So one of those things that everybody thinks about when we talk about breast cancer is chemotherapy, right? Your favorite topic, obviously. How do you decide, you know, why do some cancers need chemotherapy and why do some not need chemotherapy?
So I'm a medical oncologist, right? So chemo is my wheelhouse.
Right.
But it's probably the thing that scares people the most.
Yeah.
You know, like surgery, they can get their minds around, you know, even radiation, even though it scares them, they can't. But chemo, a lot of people have heard a lot of horror stories in the movies, like people are really sick when they're getting chemo.
Yeah. It's a physical appearance too, associated
very
with
true
chemo,
very right? true physical appearance, the side effects, the whole thing. Obviously you don't want to give it to anyone who doesn't need it, so that's the first step. And we have very good personalized tests that can try to predict who needs chemo and who doesn't,
and we haven't had that for very long.
No,
right?
We haven't. We used to give chemo to everybody,
right?
Now we only give it to a proportion of patients, so we actually test the cancer, look at specific genes that are more involved in cancer wanting to get out of the breast, and as well as cancer responding to chemo,
right?
And then re-stratify patients.
Yeah.
And two-thirds of patients, and you know, that are lymph node negative, don't need chemo anymore. They can just do without it.
Yeah.
And now we've gotten to the point that even people who have 1 to 3 lymph nodes, a lot of them we can also spare from chemo with the same testing, because now we are understanding that that cancer really needs anti-hormonal therapy, which is just a simple pill,
right?
Rather than this big thing that is chemotherapy.
Yeah.
But also I think a lot of patients that end up needing chemo, I tell them that it's not as bad as you think. You know,
it's not like the movies.
It's not like the movies. Thankfully, breast cancer treatment has come a long way.
Yeah.
Even in people who do need chemotherapy, they can get through it. We manage side effects really well. Whether it's hair loss, there are things for that. Whether it's nausea, there are preventative measures for that.
Yeah.
So you will get through it if you have to do it.
Right.
But my goal is to actually spare most patients from chemotherapy and not have them do it. If I can actually do targeted agents, I can do anti-hormonal medications, things that are better in terms of efficacy and lower in terms of side effects.
So how does chemotherapy actually work on the cancer, on the cells?
So if you're giving chemo in the traditional sense of the word, then it's a blind thing that just kills anything that is quickly dividing. And sometimes if you don't have targeted things and the cancer is aggressive, you have to do that for a few cycles to try to get rid of these cancer cells.
Yeah.
So it's something IV, you come into the infusion room, you sit there for a few hours, it's not gonna hurt.
Right.
It's not gonna feel, you know, make you feel bad when you're getting it.
Right.
And
they say, this is a piece of cake.
Right.
Yeah.
So you can watch something, you can read books, whatever, but then in a few days later, you will have some fatigue, but hopefully that's about it.
Yeah.
It's not, you know, nausea, vomiting. It's not as bad as people think.
Right.
And you get through it. And a lot of the chemos now are even combined with targeted agents. Let's say you were a HER2 positive breast cancer patient, which is about 20% of breast cancers. Then you add these targeted agents that help the chemo do better.
Yeah. It's like almost finding the right place to put the chemo.
Exactly.
Right? Because chemo just kind of
goes
everything
for,
that is dividing. So that's why we get the hair loss, we get the taste, and we get some of these neuropathies. But these targeted agents are amazing, right? Because it can help us. It's like giving us the target to put the medications
right.
in and of sparing some of the things that don't need it.
And some of them actually don't cause hair loss even because they're that targeted.
Right.
So the goal is that we get more and more dose chemos for the patients who really need it, for sparing the rest, and even the ones that do need it, get it more and more targeted and less toxic. And we've come a long way. So I would tell most patients, let's see, we'll do the testing. We make absolutely certain if you need chemo. And if you do, you'll get through it. It's not that bad. A few cycles and we'll get to the other side.
Yeah, and there's so much research going on right now, right?
Yes.
I mean, I feel like, you know, medical oncology and breast is one of those things that's, it keeps moving, moving forward, and I'm always
have to keep up.
I know. This is why we needed a specialist, because I mean, I can't even keep track of all of the chemotherapy agents sometimes because there's just so many that are being developed.
No, it's very true.
And it's changing so much, right? What we gave our, you know, 20 years ago when I came out of medical school versus now
is very different.
Completely different.
Like, I feel like every year we have like few more drugs that are now approved, new indications, even new classifications of breast cancer, like HER2 low, didn't used to be a thing, and now there's a whole category of breast cancer. It really helps to see a specialist. It really helps to be treated with the cutting edge of this, because thankfully for breast cancer patients, breast cancer research is at its height, is ahead of almost every other cancer.
Yeah.
And so it helps you to be able to get the latest thing, and then hopefully a few years down the line, even better and better things come along.
Well, this is why we're so lucky to have you, right? Because, I mean, half of your hat is to do research, right? Yes. We can only get better if we are looking for ways to become better. And we really needed somebody in this role to not only take care of the patients, but also bringing some of these trials that, you know, totally go over my head, obviously.
I'm not sure about that, but yeah.
But you need a specialist, because now we can look for ways in which we can push that needle even further and make it even better, right? So that, you know, our kids won't be facing the same thing, and our kids will have a better world.
Yeah, we will not be able to move this further along unless we do this research.
Right.
Unless we get people on clinical trials, unless we do the research in the lab.
Right.
To be able to move to the next drug and the next drug after that. Like right now we have a study on a new immunotherapy drug that patients that, you know, don't qualify for anything else.
Right.
So that's amazing. And I'm super excited about
the options that we have. Exactly. It's so amazing. And even some of the trials are to try to take away some of the stuff. Right?
Mm-hmm. Right.
Because it's like you don't, you know, we're always fearful in cancer. We want to do everything we can to treat a cancer. But what's, I think, really lovely or interesting and exciting about breast cancer is like a lot of our studies are trying to peel away some of this. Like maybe we don't need to do that much.
Right.
We could actually minimize.
Which is
maybe
sometimes the hardest thing.
It is so hard, right? You know, we teach fellows all the time, right? Yeah. And I think the thing that I teach my fellows is like it's harder to say let's not do something than to just throw everything at it.
Yes.
Right? But the problem is, as a patient, when we throw everything at it, there's so many side effects.
Yeah.
Right? And are we doing them any good by doing all of this, or is it just giving them side effects? And so peeling back is just as important as finding more things to give patients. So.
Exactly. And we have trials like that that are trying to not do a drug that is standard of care otherwise. I'm watching patients super carefully to make sure that they do as well as the people that got that drug. Yeah. I get those questions all the time. Shouldn't I get also this drug and that drug?
Right.
I'm like, no, you do not need that. You do not need to throw the kitchen sink at this.
Right.
You need to be targeted.
Right.
You need to know exactly why you're doing what you're doing and give people exactly what they need, not more, not less.
Right. Too little is not good. Too much is not good because there are side effects. So it's got to be Goldilocks.
That's
it, right? It's got to be just right for that person.